And this year we said our theme for the year is what? Consider Jesus. Amen. Amen. We say what? Consider Jesus. When somebody says consider, what do you understand by the word consider? They are trying to look for the meaning of consider, the word consider. And there are so many adjectives and meanings for that word consider. Amen. Amen. I just want to read some. It says, well, when somebody says consider, say give careful thought to that particular thing that he's talking about. Amen. He said careful thought. Be attentive. Analyze it. Esteem it. Appraise. Assess. Amen. You see, and when you do these things, it gives you a possibility of taking an action. Amen. And it's also what it gives you an ability to think about this thing in order to what, make or decide on an issue. And that's what we are talking about this morning. Pastor talked about this speech topic some time ago this month, this year. Consider Jesus. Amen.
Amen.
And when he said consider Jesus, Jesus is the word of God. The Bible says that in the beginning was the word. And the word was of God. So when we say consider Jesus, I'm trying to say consider the word of God. Amen.
Amen.
For us to survive in this time, it's going to take the word of God. Amen.
Amen.
See, the people, they rested on the words of Hezekiah. That means that there's something in this thing that we need to consider.
Yes.
We've done it our way for a long time, and things are just not working out. This morning, I'm here to just lay before you that word, consider the word of God. Amen.
Amen.
Let us consider Jesus. Consider him. And that's what we try and talk about this morning. Just try and bring out some things, and let's talk about it. And just, Bible says that in the olden days, when the people of Israel came from, when they came from Egypt, and they got to Mount Sinai, Bible says that on Mount Sinai, it was so holy that even animals, when they touched the mountains, they died. Amen.
Amen.
The congregation had to stay somewhere, and Moses always had to go and listen to what God had to say and come and talk to them. Amen.
Amen.
By this time, in Jesus Christ's era, in the dispensation of grace, he said, come and let us reason together. He's calling us to come so that we can reason together. That means that, you know, from the beginning of the creation, God's plan has always been out that he will have, let us create man so that we'll have fellowship with one another. Amen. That was in the cool of the day, he walked in the garden so that he could have fellowship with Adam and Eve. That has been his desire all along. That was we're created for his pleasure. We are and we're created for God's pleasure so that he could have fellowship with us. Unfortunately, sin came on board and everything was destroyed. But I would say that before the foundations of the earth, the lamb was already slain. He made provision. His own goal is what? To get us close to him.
Yes.
He said, come and let us reason together. And this morning, that's what I want to tell you. Come and let's consider the word of God together. Come, let us consider Jesus Christ together. It's so critical for us to survive in this era. We need to consider Jesus Christ. Amen.
Amen.
If we are going to make it, well, he said, if I don't cut the time short or if I don't come early, even the very elect will not survive. Look at what's going on now. Nothing surprises me anymore. Anything at all is happening now.
Yes.
Anything at all.
Yes.
You know, the least this happens and somebody, I don't know whether you know about the governor of Oregon, I know, resigned. And the Secretary of State was elevated to now become the governor. And the Secretary of State is a bisexual lady, is bisexual.
Yeah. Yeah.
And all of a sudden, somebody said, oh, now the bisexuals have a voice. You know, people are looking for opportunities to do anything at all. And in this country where it's a constitution, everybody has a right, your First Amendment right to speak your mind. People are just taking advantage of that and doing just anything at all. This does not make sense. So if we are going to survive in this era, we need something else more than what's going around us. Amen. And that is the word of God. And that's what I want to tell you about. Let us consider the word of God. Consider Jesus Christ. Bible says in Hebrews 12 verse 3, Hebrews 12, verse 3. He said, for consider him that endures such contradiction of sinners against himself, lest you be worried and faint in your minds. Amen.
Amen.
Let's consider. In his era, this was God himself talking to, and people still did what they did. And if he had to go through all these things, You know that if the master had to go through it, then you, the servant, you will go through worse. Amen. But he told us, Lord, be of good cheer, for I have overcome the world. Be of good cheer, because he has taken the lead. He's made provisions for us. Amen. Now, he said, we are the righteousness. We being the righteousness of God has nothing to do with what we do or what somebody tells you. Amen. There's nothing that we can do to purchase the righteousness of God. It was imputed upon us because of the death on the cross. Amen.
Amen.
And he made provisions that when we fall, we get forgiveness of sins and we come back on board. Amen.
Amen.
But the devil is taking advantage of that. And he's just trying to make people. So when he's saying, he thinks that's it. And people just shy away from church. I'm here to tell you today that never run away from God. Amen.
Amen.
Never, no matter what it is. Because the solution is always with God. Amen.
Amen.
It doesn't lie anywhere outside of God. Amen. The solution is always with God. And he's the solution. Amen. If you make a mistake, go right to him. Amen. He is your father. Hey, listen, he is your father. He said, come and let us reason together. And I'm going to give us two examples of people who, what he means by this thing. It's so, 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 so important. Amen. Because we need to know him for us to consider him. If we don't know him, then there's nothing to consider. Amen.
Amen.
But how do you know God? You have to make an effort to know him. And the good and the strange thing about this whole thing is that when you get to know God, what people have told you about him, Job said about it becomes a hearsay. Amen.
Amen.
It is true. I mean, people read the Bible and they tell you, preach, and you love the preaching. But when you get to know God for himself and he reveals himself to you personally, you don't need anybody else to tell you who he is. Amen.
Yeah.
When Job went through everything that he had gone through and he was saying everything, and then in verse chapter 35 going, God started questioning himself, I will talk to you like a man. Answer me like a man. And he started telling him about everything, how he created the world. Were you there when I did this? When you there, I did that. Then at the end of it all, in chapter 42, Job came forward and said, I am sorry for everything I said. I didn't know what I was talking about. That everything that everybody has told me is hearsay. Because before, I heard about you. But now, my eyes see you. Amen.
Amen.
When you get close to God, and you get to know God, and you get a revelation of God, and you see him for yourself, you don't need anything else to tell you that this is what you need to hold on to.
Yeah.
And this is what we need to consider. We need to know God for ourselves, for us to consider him. You've done it your way for a long time. Every one of us, we've done it our way for a long time. This morning, I'm here to encourage you to consider Jesus Christ. So I want to read this story in Mark 5, 26. Mark 5, 26. I'm sure we all know this story. Mark chapter 5, verse 26. I'm sure you all know this story. You see, he had suffered many things of many physicians. I'm one of them, so. He has spent all that he had and was nothing bettered and rather grew out worse. Amen.
Amen.
This is the woman of the issue of blood. Let's go to the next verse. And when she had heard of Jesus and came in to press behind and touch his garment, she said, if I may touch his clothes, I shall be whole. Amen. And straight away, the fountain of the blood was dried up. Amen. There was something. Look at what she said. She had tried everything that she, and that's what we are doing now. There are so many theories around now. So many theories. Today they tell, and in medicine, that's what we will do anyway. It's all evidence. Everything is evidence-based. So they give you evidence, recommendation A. A means that it's the strongest evidence that they have. There's B and all those things. And then in 5 years' time, somebody will come and say, those things were all wrong. You know, you said that you couldn't eat eggs because the yolk and cholesterol. Now they say, no, egg, you have to eat egg. It's really good. So now that tells you that, listen, everything a man tells us, you can't depend on it. Amen. Because man is telling things that the evidence that you're using is what was created by another man. The evidence that men are basing their decisions on. Or depending on what men have done in the past. Amen.
Amen.
The Bible says God, he calls things out of nothing. Amen.
Amen.
And when he tells you that it is this, you know for sure that it's going to happen.
Yes.
You know for sure. You see what? Everything is held in place by the power of his word. Everything that you see around you. Bible says, in the beginning, God created the heavens and then the earth. The earth was without form, and the Spirit of God was moving upon the surface, and he spoke his word. Let there be, and there was. We need that word. For that word to create that life that you expect, that thing that you've been looking forward to, you need to hold on to that word. Amen.
Amen.
But it's very important that, like I'm saying, I'm considering that we need to consider the word and consider Jesus Christ. There's one thing that we needed above all things, and that is the Spirit of God. That is the only thing. He's the only one that will make us be able to do all this time we're talking about, considering the word of God. Amen. The Spirit of God. Because the word came to Mary that you're going to conceive a son, and his name, all those things. And Mary asked the angel, how shall this be? And then he said, the Spirit of God shall overshadow you. Amen.
Amen.
And that is when the seed is formed. Amen. It is the Spirit that will form that seed. And that seed is the word of God. Pastor said last week, in fact, it was so true, that the more you get close to God, the more he plants the seed. And the more you get to know him more. Amen.
Amen.
We are so, nothing is happening in our midst because we are so weak. There's nothing in us. Amen. The least thing, and we are all running around. The least thing, everybody's running. Because there's no foundation in our life. But for you to survive as a Christian in this time, for whatever God said concerning your life to come to pass, you need the word of God, and you need the Spirit of God breathing over that word. Amen.
Amen.
That word will take root, that seed will take root in your life. And then you shall begin to experience the revelation of that word, the fruit of that word. It's very, very important. It is not what people are telling us. You need to know God for yourself. Amen. Every one of us, I'm saying, let's consider Jesus this morning. Let's consider the word, because you need to know the word for you to consider it. If you don't know the word, what are you considering? This church, I'm not talking about Gateway, I'm talking about the Church of Christ. It was built upon a revelation, and that revelation was the word of God. Amen.
Amen.
Jesus asked them, what do men say? Who do men say I am? The first question was, who do men? He didn't ask them, who do they? They were like, who do men? And they all started saying their thing. Some say you are Elijah, some say, but he asked them, but who do you say I am? It's going to come down to you. It's not about any other person. It's about you and you alone. You and God. And for us to consider God, we need to know God first. Say, who do men say I am? And what the people tell you, you are the Christ, the Son of the living God. And so flesh and blood did not reveal this to you. It is the Spirit of God. We need the Spirit of God to serve. We need the Spirit of God to get this word of God in our hearts. Amen.
Amen.
The reason why I'm saying that is because, listen, when you look through the history of the Bible, these Israelites who came from Egypt, they saw the Red Sea part. They walked through the Red Sea. It closed on the Egyptians. They got to the other side, and they still said, the first commandment that he gave, thou shalt not create any other God beside me. They did the first thing that they did. So that tells you that it's not just seeing or hearing. Something else, there's more to it than that.
Yes, yes.
The Spirit of God, there's more to it than that. They saw, and Aaron was the spokesman. For Aaron, he was the spokesman. When Moses asked him, why did you do this thing? He said, the people told me. They were putting pressure on him. He was out there trying to get the information from God. You stand here and hold the fort for me. They came to him, and then he just created a God for them. And they did everything that you could just imagine. They saw everything. They saw everything. What else do you want to see? The Red Sea part, and you walk in the Red Sea. He did everything for them. He did everything for them. But the first thing, they created a God. Just because he was there for 40 years, they couldn't wait. So it was so when Christ was living, he told the disciples, wait, tarry till the Holy Spirit comes. Because he knew that that was the only thing that was going to carry the work across. Amen. Amen. So I'm talking about two things now. There are two main things, the word of God and the spirit of God. But we need the spirit of God to implant this word in our lives. Amen. Amen. Because the word, the revelation of the word only comes by the spirit of God. Bible says it's only the spirit of a man that knoweth the mind of that man. Amen.
Amen.
It is only that. So if we are going to dwell with the spirit of God, you see, the spirit of God will know the mind of God. And Bible says that the thing that God has prepared for you, no eye has seen, no ear has heard, no heart of man has perceived it. What God has in store for them that love him. Amen.
Amen.
So that means that for us to know what God, the purpose of God, Bible says we are created for his pleasure. For you to know that pleasure of God, the reason why he put you here on earth, you need to dwell. You need to engage the spirit of God. You need to engage the spirit of God. Let the spirit of God have his own way in you. Amen. And the spirit of God is going to be fed by the word of God. That's the fuel of the spirit. The word of God. Because see, the spirit was brooding and the word came and it became, let there be and there was. Amen.
Amen.
The power for the word to create is the spirit of God. We need that spirit. We need to dwell. We need to engage the spirit. He has given his own. I like that song. For giving us your spirit until your work on earth is done. We need the word of God. We need the word of God, but we need the spirit. See what? How will this be? How will this be? That's Mary's question to the angel. He said, don't worry. The Spirit of God will overshadow you.
Amen.
The Spirit of God will overshadow you. And that's why you want to cry every morning in your life. That the Spirit of God overshadow you. That as you study the Word of God, as you imbibe the Word of God, and the Spirit comes, a seed will form in you. And when it's time, see, in his own time, he will make all things beautiful. In his own time, God will make all things beautiful. You know, and the reason I'm saying this is because, I don't know, but I know how to put it. Look at Isaiah. We did this Bible study in Isaiah 6. When Isaiah was in the year that King Uzziah died. Amen. I saw the Lord. Amen. But when you read that, you see that he gets the point. That when he saw the Lord, he felt that he was an evil person. He was a sinner. Amen. This was a prophet of God. This was Isaiah, the prophet of God. I tell you that what? So that for him, when he saw God for himself, everything that he had done in the past didn't compare to what he was seeing. That's how it is. That's how the revelation of God, when he gets the revelation of God, everything that's happened doesn't compare to what you're seeing. Everything that there's men of God, you've heard about men of God, and these are true men of God. When you see God for yourself and God reveals himself to you, everything else doesn't compare. Amen.
Amen.
Everything else doesn't compare. All you feel like doing is just letting go, giving it your all. Amen.
Amen.
Giving it, and that's what Isaiah did. Send me, I will go. It wasn't that Isaiah was an evil person, but when he saw the revelation of God, that God is in entire holiness, everything else didn't compare. And that's something to encourage you. That we have to make that effort. Listen, God wants to reveal himself to us individually and as a church. Amen.
Amen.
But we have to make the effort. When you look, let's open to Ezekiel chapter 3, verse 1. He wants to reveal himself to us. He wants to show himself. He wants to open himself up to us. But we have to make the effort. We have to study. Amen. To show ourselves approved, to know him for ourselves. Because when we do, we'll have rest. Amen.
Amen.
And that's what we need. But there's nothing that you can do to overcome what's going on nowadays. Everybody's confused. Look at the presidents and whoever, they are all confused. Amen. Moreover, he said unto me, son of man, eat that thou findest. Eat this roll and go speak unto the house of Israel. Go to verse 2. So I opened my mouth, and he caused me to eat that roll. Amen.
Amen.
We have to do the opening. Amen.
Amen.
So I opened my mouth. He's talking the word of God. Go to verse 3. And he said unto me, son of man, cause thy belly to eat, and fill thy bowels with this roll that I give thee. Then did I eat it, and it was in my mouth as honey for sweetness. Amen.
Amen.
So You see how the goats or the cow, is it ruminants? Or, you see, they eat and they eat fast and they go and lie down and they take their time. Yeah. Watch and they chew things and they, you know? So he started to, see, he filled his belly with the food. He allowed it to fill his bowels. Amen. You know, bowels, it's the small and the, you know, that, and that's where the true action takes place. The small intestine. The stomach doesn't do anything. It just makes things soft. But the actual thing happens what in the bowel. That's where the action takes, the absorption and all those things. And he said, and I did, and it was in my mouth, honey for sweetness. What that means is that when the revelation of the word came, it tasted like honey for sweetness. Amen. But he had to take his time. It was no rush. He had to open his mouth and eat it. That one, nobody can do it for you. You have to do it yourself. You have to do the opening of the mouth. You have to do the studying. You have to do the praying. You have to do the fasting. You have to do all those things, the fellowshipping, everything. You have to listen to the word of God from other people. You know, you have to do all those things. You have to do those things. Then the Spirit of God comes and does the what? The sweetness. Gives you the sweetness. Because that's where the revelation comes. So he took his time. Got the food, it takes time to go all the way. We see how it's time. When they stretch your intestine out, I'll tell you, it's so long, you believe it. You have to see one to believe it. Because it's folded on itself, and it's put in there. That's why the abdomen can go so big. You know? Have you seen somebody who has the... You see? So it doesn't. So that tells you, that it takes time. It takes time to travel all... So it takes time. It doesn't come overnight. You have to work at it. You have to stay at it. You know, we are in a country where everything is right now. What I say, Apple Pay, PayPal, everything. Very soon, we have to look into things and you pay things. You pay for things. Very soon. Listen, we are getting there. You just use your eyes and you pay. You see that? Amen. But that's why the world is running so fast. Everything is moving. So the country that I come from, listen. That is something called doom so. People don't hear, don't know what it is. Eh? The light goes off. Here, if the light goes off right now, people will just, you know, but things are moving so fast. So we came from a country where we're used to darkness. Hey, it happens. We see the tap goes off, we go and carry water and all those things. The day I took my children to Ghana and they saw people carrying food on their head. Oh my God. Daddy, why are they carrying food on their head? But, you know, things are changing so fast. We come here and yeah, and you're laughing, hey, but mommy, that's why I was born. I knew I'm used to that. But things are changing so fast. So we are also turning Christianity into like you have to press buttons. No. It doesn't work like that. It takes time. You have to eat the scroll. Amen.
Amen.
You have to sit down, think about it, concentrate on it, read it. Every day you go at it. The thing may not be coming to you, go at it. Amen. When the Spirit of God brings the revelation, it will make up for all everything that you think you've lost. It will make up for it. Amen. Bible says in his own time, he will make everything beautiful. See, everything will work together for your good. Don't worry about what happened on the road. Listen, at the end of it all, everything that you thought was bad or was not good, and why this, everything will fit in. Amen. Everything will fit. The thing is that we always see, you know, when you are going, all that you can see is just behind you. Amen. Mm-hmm. But God sits on top. He can see, that's why he sees the beginning from the end. He can see the end and you can also see the beginning. Amen. Yes. We saw how he destroyed the Egyptians in the Red Sea. First of all, what did he say? The last person, the wheels of the cart just came off. So he couldn't go forward, he couldn't go back. And the same thing happened to the first guy. So now they were stuck. They couldn't go forward and they couldn't go back. And that's when he knocked them out. Amen. He sits on top there. He sees the end and he sees the beginning. Amen. We only see the guy next behind us. So we are always screaming, oh, he's coming. But God is doing his work. Amen. We need to take time. It takes time. It takes time. You have to give it your all. Listen, leave it all on the table. And what are you going to lose? What are you going to lose if we give it all and it doesn't happen? What are you going to lose? The life that we are living now, you enjoy it. Listen. People think that they are having fun. It's all of troubles. Mm-hmm. People are buying debt. They smoke and they are buying. You work hard, you get money, and you go and buy debt. And that's what we are doing now. Yeah. They work hard. I mean, they work hard. This country, you know how we work hard. And then we get our money, and then we go and pay for them. Where are we going? So I'm giving another option now. I say, consider Jesus Christ. Consider the word of God. Consider God. Amen. Because there's something like, something. I want to read Job 5, verse 8. Let's read Job 5, verse 8. I will seek unto God, and unto God will I commit my cause. Amen. Let's go to the next verse. Yeah. Which doeth great things and unsearchable marvelous things without number. Amen. And you see that there's a, no, go back. So you see that there's a colon. You see the colon there? That means that anytime you see that colon, that means that God is going to give you examples of those things. That He can't give you everything, but He's going to give you examples of those things. Amen. I'm not going to read all, but when you get a chance, you can read it. Go to the next one. He giveth rain upon the earth and sendeth what? There are so many things. But let's go to the last verse on that. I think it's 26. Verse 26. Yeah, 27. That's it. When you read that, there are so many things that God does for us. So many things. He keep you in famine, in war. He will keep you in wars. None of your children will be destroyed or lost. So the last verse, this is what he said. He said, lo, this, we have searched it. So it is. Hear it and know it for thy good. Amen.
Amen.
He was trying to tell us that he was going to commit his cause to God. He was trying to encourage us to commit our cause to God. What it is, the reason why we make decisions, we make things, we run around, because we are trying to get solutions to our issues. Amen. There's so many problems. When you read this thing, he will tell you that, when you read verse 7, he will tell everyone, man is born unto trouble. Trouble doesn't come from the ground. It just comes to us. Amen.
Amen.
But then the verse is still not, but I'm just encouraging you to commit your cause to God. Amen.
Amen.
Because God is the one, the solution lies with God. The solution, it lies with God. It doesn't lie with any other man. Amen.
Amen.
Because that man that you're going to depend on, he also has his own problems that he's fighting. He hasn't found his solutions yet. So why are you going to rely on that man? Why? But unfortunately, we always go for the point of least resistance. We want to get something quick to fix. Oh no, put some bandage over it and then jump to the next thing. And then the thing just festers and becomes something else, something that could have been solved earlier. Amen.
Amen.
But because we are always in a rush, we want to get things done just like that, because we are used to things being, and then we are just going. It's patience with God. Amen.
Amen.
Because he, when he does the thing and it's done, he wants it to be complete. Nobody can say, no, when God does it for you, he wants to be said that nobody can say that out. I had a role in it, or had a part in it, or you know. He wants to make sure. Abraham told the king of this Sodom, when he came from the war, that I'm not taking anything. Take everything, so that you tell me that you made me prosper. No. But this thing that just doesn't come is somebody who knows God. Amen.
Amen.
He has known God for himself, and this was somebody who at that time didn't have a son. He was just living on the word of God. But against hope, he hoped. Against hope, he was hoping. And he trusted God. Even to the he trusted God. And something that God did for Abraham, I don't know whether you, but when you look at that whole family, Abraham lied about Sarah. Isaac also lied about Rebecca. They all said the same thing, that this is my sister. This is my sister. They all said. And God prayed Abimelech, you are a dead man. You are a dead man. If you touch Sarah, you know that he was a lie, but God was still protecting him. You know what I'm saying? If you want to leave it all on the table for God, you want to the things that the lengths that God will go for you, you have no idea. If you're going to give it all and leave it all on the table for God, there are going to be tough times. There are going to be difficult times. That's why he said in Hebrews 12:3, that consider who we endure such contradiction of sinners. So that you don't go weary. Amen. There are going to be tough times. That one, I can promise you, there are going to be tough times. If the master had to go through it, you, the servant, will go through it also. But I want you to know one thing, that if you're going to leave it all and trust and hold on to the word of God and hang on to the word of God, the lengths that God will go for you, you have no idea.
Amen.
Amen. The lengths that God will go for us. Let's read Psalm 18. I'm going to read what the things that God will do. Psalm 18, verse 1. The lengths that God will go for us, we have no idea. We are yet to even fathom the depths of the thing that God will do for us. Psalm 18, verse 1. So, where does it start? The servant of the Lord, who spake unto the Lord the words of this song in the day that the Lord delivered him from the hand of all his enemies and from the hand of Saul. And he said, I love thee, O Lord, my strength. Go to the next one, next verse. The Lord is my rock and my fortress, my deliverer, my God, my strength, in whom I will trust, my backbone of my salvation and my high tower. I will call upon the Lord, who is worthy to be praised. So shall I be saved from my enemies. The sorrows of death compassed me. So you know, he's trying to tell us what. And the floods of ungodly men made me afraid. The sorrows of hell compassed me about, and the snares of death prevented me. In my distress, I called upon the Lord, and I cried unto my God, and he heard my voice out of his temple, and my cry came before him, even unto his ears. And then he starts, God starts, goes on, gets to work. Verse 7. And the earth shook and trembled, and the foundations also of the hills moved and were shaken, because he was wroth. There went a smoke out of his nostrils, and fire out of his mouth devoured, and coals were kindled by it. He bowed the heavens also, and came down, and darkness was under his feet. But if you go on, the things that, I think the depths that God will go for you. You see, he made his cry unto God. God heard his cry. He got into the end. The earth, because God was mad. He rode the cherub, did fly. You have to read the whole of the chapter 18, and you see the things that God did. Amen.
Amen.
The depths that God will go for us if we are going to take him at his word, if we are going to consider him as the first option and only option. Amen. There are no options. He is the only option. Amen. Sorry, he's the first and only option. We need to consider God. But all this thing comes down to the one thing. You need to know God for yourself. Amen.
Amen.
Because you need that revelation for yourself. I can tell you everything. I can give you the testimony. Anybody can give you the testimonies. But in the heat of that moment, if you don't know God for yourself, anything at all will sway you off. You know? And that's why he said, wait, tarry in Jerusalem till the Spirit comes. Amen. Tarry. The same people who said, Peter, the same person who said, I don't know him, 3 times. When the Spirit of God came, I would say he spoke and 3,000 words were converted. And then when they were taken to the Sanhedrin and they were being beaten up, he said, you tell us who we should believe, man or God. Amen. This thing did not come because Peter was a fisherman. Amen. He said they were unlearned men, but the Spirit of God made all the difference. When he spoke, they realized this was different from the one that we know. Amen. But we need to commit to God, because the depths that God will go for us, we have no idea. If only we will commit to him. If only we will give in to all everything that he's saying. And we just engage the Spirit of God. And let the Spirit of God have his own way in our lives. He will breathe over that word of God in you. That word will take seed. And when the word of God takes seed, you know it's going to germinate. Amen. It's good. And the fruits of the word of God, you cannot even begin to enjoy it. But the revelation will only come by the Spirit of God. We need to know God. I'm saying that we have to make the opening of the mouth. You have to open your mouth and eat the roll. You need to eat the scroll. Amen. And you have to allow the Spirit of God to work on that word. And this thing is even more urgent now. Urgent now, the way things are going. Amen. Look at what these people are doing. ISIS. Can you just imagine? 10 years ago, can you imagine what we are seeing now? But now it's become a norm for us. Amen. It happens and life goes on. You know, it happens and life goes on. It happens, we all scream, hey, and then life goes on. Everybody forgets, hey, life goes on. But they also think that they are serving a God. As to which God they are serving, we don't know. But they also think that, you know how the devil can just take over a mind and just mess it up. Amen. So if the devil can do that, if we are going to allow our spirit, we are going to allow ourselves for the Holy Ghost to use us and have full control over our lives, can we imagine the things that he will do? Can we just imagine the things that he will do? Amen. But we have to make that effort. He gave us that free will. That's why he gave us that free will. If we will submit it back to him and let him have his, do his own work, instead of saying, allow the word of God to do its work in you. Amen. I was trying to find this, but I couldn't find it. When the Bible says, like, allow the word of God to do its work in you. Amen. That like you take the word of God and you allow it to do its work in you. So that you realize that it's not, people say that Christianity is, don't do this, don't do, no. When the word of God does its work in you, you don't feel like doing anything else but just pleasing him. So there's no do's and don'ts. Amen. There's no do's and don'ts in Christianity. Because when the word of God is doing its work in you, your only desire is to please God. So there's nothing like do's and don'ts. Because you don't even feel like doing the other thing anyway. Because the edge is not there anymore. But we have to give ourselves to the word of God. I'm here to tell you, let us give it our all. You know, let us give it our all. Let us give it. And this means that we have to support each other. You know, we give up easily on each other. Easily. The least thing, let it go away. Amen. We give up easily. We need to fight for one another. We need to stand in the gap. We need to work for one another. Amen. We need to cover one another. It's so, I don't know, but it's something that we need to do. If you want to see this church go to the next level, amen. We need to care for one another. And that's why the churches in the, when Paul's time, they contributed for the poor churches. Every week, everybody put something aside. So when they come, they give. And they carry that money to the poor churches, amen. They didn't know them. But it was there. They felt like they had to do it, amen. And that is what we need to do in this time. We need to care for one another. We need to do that. We give up easily on ourselves, so that's why we give up easily on other people. But this morning, I'm here to encourage us that we need to stay the course. Amen. We need to stay the course. We need it. The purpose of God in your life, that revelation, is going to be built upon that revelation of the word of God that's in your life. That God's word that he's giving you. He said, Simon by Jonah, flesh and blood did not reveal this to you. By the Spirit of God. Amen. And upon this rock, upon that revelation, amen. Jesus Christ being the chief cornerstone. He is the foundation is already built. Amen. There's no other foundation that you can lay. You just need to hold on to that word. Because the foundation is all, and that once you hold on to that word, you can build, you know what you are standing on. Amen. He said, upon this rock, I will build my church. And the gates of hell shall not prevail against it. Amen. This for your family, for your life, for our church, everywhere you go. That is the revelation. The purpose of God for your life, for it to come to pass, you need that revelation. That revelation, you need to hold on to that. You need to search for it and let the Spirit of God reveal it to you. Amen. Amen. Let the Spirit of God reveal it to you. Listen, he gave his Spirit. That's the reason why he gave his Spirit. He said, I'm going, but the person, the comforter, I'm going, but my Father will send you the comforter. He will comfort you. Amen. In your time of distress, he will comfort you. The word of God, you think that it's just the word of God. It may be letters. Amen. But what brings it to life is the Spirit of God. Amen. Jesus Christ said, the Spirit of God, when it comes, it shall testify of me. And he said that the word that I speak to you, they are life and they are spirit. We are just human beings here, but you are a spirit. This body, it will all go away. Amen. That's why as you grow, your body starts wrinkling. Listen, they can do age-defying creams and all those things. Listen, when it's time, it will go down. Forget it. When it's time, it will go down. They can do whatever they want to do. They tell us everything just to get your money anyway. And we'll keep putting chemicals and chemicals. Listen, but if your spirit is alive, you don't care about the body. Because if the spirit is alive, the body will survive. Amen. Because anytime the spirit lives, the body doesn't exist anymore anyway. So let's feed the spirit, and that is the word of God. Amen. The spirit of God is food of the spirit, is the word of God. You feed the spirit, you pray, you fast. Amen. We give option to the Spirit of God. Because it's a fight, a constant fight between the flesh and the spirit. Amen. And you are the referee. You decide who wins. Amen.
Amen.
We decide who wins, whether it's the spirit or the flesh. I was like, cursed is any man. Cursed is every man. If your arm or strength is flesh, you are cursed. Amen.
Amen.
So, yeah, that time is really running. So I've said so many things this morning that the depths that God will go for us, the depths that God will go for us, if we will give ourselves to him, eyes have not seen, nor ears heard, nor in the heart of men perceived what God has in store for them. He told the, let's look at Mark 5:50. I just want to look at, that's Mark 5:50. Mark chapter 5, verse 15. Verse 50. Oh, there's no 50. Is it Mark? It's Mark. Sorry. What did I call? No. Luke. Okay, let's go to Luke. Luke 8, verse 50. Let me spell it. Yes, Luke 8:50. Sorry. Amen. So this story actually follows the story of the woman with the issue of blood. Amen. So this was the army general who came to Jesus Christ. Her daughter was sick, and he came to ask for help. Amen. Let's go to 49. Yeah. So whilst he was talking to Jesus Christ, whilst he yet spake, there cometh one from the ruler of the synagogue's house, saying to him, "Thy daughter is dead. Trouble not the master anymore." Amen. Trouble not the master. And then 50. And when Jesus heard it, he answered, saying, "Fear not, believe only." Amen.
Amen.
Fear not, believe only, and she shall be made whole. He said, "I'm the resurrection and the life." Last week I told you that anywhere that Jesus Christ went, there was always life. Death never happened, had its way. Anywhere that he went, amen. If he came on scene, the scene, death had to leave. Amen.
Amen.
And if you go to take that one and keep that one in the depths of your heart, that anywhere that Christ comes, if he comes on the scene, that he may be dead. But when he comes on the scene, because he's the resurrection and he also the life. So he has the life and he's also able to bring that which is dead to life. Amen.
Amen.
So he said, while he was telling Jesus Christ, and when he heard that, he said, he said, "Fear not, only believe." And that's my word for you. I'm going to live with you. Fear not, only believe, and she shall be made whole. Whatever it is that's in your life, whatever it is, whatever you think that is, this one there is beyond repair. It's beyond repair. This one, I'm done. This one, there's nothing. He said, "Fear not, only believe. And she shall be made whole." Whatever it is, it shall be made whole. He just telling us not to fear. Oh, if only we can believe. And that's where the thing is. If only. That's what he said. So that's what he said. Oh, the disciples asked about he should heal their unbelief. The Bible said he couldn't do anything in his own country because of what? Unbelief. So he said, only believe. That's when they gave him the bad news. When they say, the person is dead, forget about it. But to man, that's it. Here, he's dead. It's over. There's nothing more man could do. So just leave him alone. He says, no. Fear not. Only believe, and he shall be made whole. Yeah? Only believe. God will always do beyond, far beyond what you can ever imagine or think or in your. Is there anything that you can dare to believe or imagine? God is able to do far above and beyond that. That's the God that we are serving. Anything that you can dare, that means you're dare, whatever you can dare in your heart, anything that you can imagine, He's able to do far beyond that. So there's something more to this that we need to consider. I'm just this one here to just say that. Let's consider him. If you've done it all, the lady had tried everything. He had given all his money, everything. And the things were still getting worse. Amen. Amen. And he said to himself, if only I would touch the tip of his clothes, I'll be made whole. He came. These things don't come. No, these things don't come. You know, this kind of inspiration, they just don't come. That's where the Spirit of God comes in. These things just don't come. The Spirit of God gives you this kind of inspirations. The same thing happened to Esther when Mordecai told her that you think that you're going to be free. No, when they start killing, they're going to kill all of us. But help will come from somewhere. And he says, no. Okay, now let us fast. And you see what he said, if I perish, I perish. She was even to the point of consecrating herself to God and was willing to die. Amen. But he just gave it all, left it all on the table. Amen. And that is what God wants to see in our lives. Amen. Let us give it our all. Let's be open and let's take his way all the time. Amen. Amen. He's the only option and the only choice. Amen. Amen. Anything else beside God is false. Amen. Amen. It may look like, but it is not. Amen. Obviously, the devil, he goes around like a lion, but we have the lion of the tribe of Judah. The devil goes like, but we have the lion of the tribe of Judah. So if the devil says, oh, we say, ah. Amen. Amen. Because the lion, we have the lion. Amen. He is like, but we have. So this morning, I just want to encourage us to consider Jesus. Amen. Let us consider Jesus. Let us consider the word of God. Because there's so much in store for us. He wants to do so much for us. There's so much that he wants to do for us. Only if we allow him to do it. Amen. We allow his word to take root in us. Amen. And let his spirit come over us and overshadow us. That word will take root. Job said, I desire your word more than my necessary food. I desire your word more than my necessary food. That's what Job said. That's what Job said before he... So, and then he said the same thing. At the end of it all, he said, everything I've heard about you was hearsay. Now my eyes have seen you. Let's go for that revelation. Let's go for that word of God. Open your mouth and eat the roll. Amen. Eat the scroll and let the Spirit of God tabernacle with you. Let the Spirit of God bring that revelation. It shall be sweet in your mouth. Amen. And I want to let you know that the depths that God will go for you, eyes have not seen, nor ears heard, nor the heart of man perceived what God has prepared for them that love him. Hallelujah. Amen. Amen.